Hi children, welcome, good morning one and all. In today's video class, I'm going to narrate the third chapter of the snapshots, that is Renga's marriage. It's a humorous and a very interesting story. Before to enter the story, let me give you a brief account of the author. Do you know who was the author of this story? Masti Venkatesha Iyengar. He was the author of this story. Actually, let me give you a brief account of this author or the writer. He was a well-known Canada writer. Most of his writings are in his mother tongue, that is in Canada language. And he was honored with the Jnanpith Award. He was the recipient of Jnanpith Award, the award given to those who has made excellent contribution in the field of literature. So he was the recipient of Jnanpith Award. He was also known and well known for his short stories. So he is a renowned short story writer, and he wrote most of the stories under the pen name Srinivasa. So these are all about the author. So he was a writer in Canadian language, in Canada language, and he was honored with the Jnanpith Award, the best award for the field of literature. And he was a renowned short story writer. And more than that, he wrote all his stories under the pen name Srinivasa. Okay, next, let me give you a brief account about the story. This story is about what? This story is about a young village man. His name is, actually, see, Renga. He's a young village man, and this story, Renga's marriage, deals with that young village man. How was he? How he had been brought up? Where he studied, and how he got married. So this story has been knitted around Renga and his marriage. Okay, fine. So in this story, we are going to see in detail who was Renga and how he was brought up in that village atmosphere, and about his basic and higher education, how he got married, whom he got married, who helped him to get married. All these things we are going to see in detail in this story. Okay, fine. About the village of Kosahalli. Actually, this story has a strong base of a village life. About 10 years ago, about a decade ago, there was a village, that is Kosahalli. It is 10 years ago, it was in Mysore state. But now it is a part of Karnataka state. So 10 years ago, this village Kosahalli was in Mysore state. But now it is a part of Karnataka state. And the people, those who are living in this village, speak Kannada. Actually, this village is generally called South Indian village, because it has all the features of South Indian village. And more than that, a decade ago, 10 years ago, it is very rare to find English speaking people in that village, because their mother tongue is Kannada. They used to speak only in Kannada. They have their communication in Kannada. Okay, fine. Then they are, actually, it is humorously set, before a long time, this village Kosahalli actually was not in the map. It is very famous for sour mango. So Kosahalli was a part of Mysore state long time back, but now it is a part of Karnataka state. It was a South Indian village. The people living in that village speaks Kannada. It is very rare to find people, those who are good in English communication, or it is very rare to find English speaking people in the village. And a long time back, actually, this village was not at all in the map. It is very famous for sour mango. Then a few words about the people. Let me explain the nature and the attitude of the people, those who are living in the village. Okay, fine. These village people are very innocent. The village people were very innocent and they were very conservative. Blind belief, that is called a conservative. They have their own orthodox belief. Orthodox belief, it is very rare for them to come out of that belief. So these people were highly conservative and orthodox. They have set principles. They were never ready to give up their principle for anything. That is the attitude of these people, the Kosagali village people. And they have strong belief in caste and community. They have strong belief in caste and community. They are traditional bounded. These people are traditionally bounded people. And they are the believers of astrology. They had a strong belief in astrology. What the stars says, what the astrologer says, that will happen. They believe the astrologer. They believe astrology. They called it as a science, a part of a science. It is also a science. Okay, so I hope children can follow me well. So you should know the location of the Kosagali, that is the village. And you must know about the attitude and attitude of the people, those who were living in the village. Next, let me explain the role of English in that village. Role of English. The people actually, it is rare to find people, those who are good in English. But they have a good regards for the language. Role of English. Actually, long time ago, it is very rare to find English speaking people in that village. But they have a good place for the language. They considered it as an important language. They feel knowing English is very essential. They give respect to that language. They give respect to the people who speaks English also. But at the same time, they believe that learning of a modern language should not affect their custom, their tradition, and their caste and community. Okay, so English is considered as an important language by the people of this Kosagali village. They give respect to the learners of English. They give respect to the people who speaks English well. They recommend, they welcome, they invite the people, those who would like to learn English. They give due regards for that language. They have a good place in their heart for the language learning. They feel that learning a modern language is very essential and important for the village people. But at the same time, they did not allow the learning of modern language to affect their tradition and culture. Because these people are traditionally bounded people and they never yield to the pressure. They never give up their tradition and culture for anything. Okay, so this is about the role of English in that village. Next, Kosagali is a village, South Indian ideal and a typical South Indian village. And it is very rare to find people, those who communicate with others in English. It is very rare. And speaking English and the importance of English is not widespread in that village. That's the main reason. The importance of English has not been widespread in that village. When the situation was like that, there was an accountant in the village. He was ready to send his son Renga for higher studies to Bangalore. Actually, in that village, no one was ready to send their wards to modern cities for higher studies or for learning English or anything else. But there was an accountant in the village. He made up his mind to send his son Renga to Bangalore for higher studies. He stayed there for 6 months. He completed his studies successfully and then he came back to his village. See, arrival of Renga. So Renga was a first boy who was sent to modern city for higher studies by his father. He was an accountant. He successfully completed his studies. After 6 months, he came back to his village. So all the people of the village were very curious and very curious to know, to find out. They were very curious to find out the changes in the attitude and aptitude of Renga, because for 6 months he had been in a modern city. They thought that city life had changed him a lot. They thought like that. They also thought that he might have given up his tradition, his culture, his strong belief on religion, his strong belief on caste and community. Hoping and expecting all these things, when the people came to know that homecoming of Renga returned to his house, home, all the people of the village gathered around his home. There was a huge crowd of people in and around his house. They want to see Renga, because the arrival or the homecoming of Renga was considered as an important event by the people in the village. Homecoming, the coming back of Renga, was considered as an important event in the village, because they never failed to give respect to Renga. They considered him as an intelligent boy. They considered him as a young man of principles, and he was the one who can speak English well. And to learn English, he was sent to Bangalore by his father. Therefore, the people of the village have high regards on him. So they gathered to see Renga. When Renga came to know that a crowd of people have come to see him off, he came out with smile on his face. He came out with a smiling face. He wished to the people, he greeted them, and the people also wished him. So when the people saw him, they came to a conclusion. There was no physical change in Renga. They were so impressed by the attitude of Renga, the way he wished to them, the way he spoke to them, impressed the village people very much. Now they came to a conclusion that there was no change in the attitude, there was no physical changes also. They come to a conclusion that they happened to see that Renga whom they had seen 6 months ago. So he was the same Renga who had gone to Bangalore for studies 6 months ago. The same Renga was there. There was no change in his attitude. After 6 months stay in the city, in the modern city, did not affect his attitude as well as aptitude. So the people were so impressed, and slowly they started to disperse, and they discussed among themselves that Renga is a good young boy of our village. Though he had gone to city for higher studies, he did not give up any of his principles and the tradition of our village. There was no change. So they discussed among themselves like that. At the same time, there was an old lady who was also among the crowd. He came very near to Renga, and she ran her hand over the chest like this. She wanted to find the holy thread, whether it was there or not. When she noticed the holy thread is still there, she was much impressed. So, higher education, city staying did not disturb him. He did not give up his tradition. The old lady came to a conclusion. After confirming the holy thread on his chest, still it has been there. So he never failed to wear the holy thread. So she assured, after assuring the holy thread, She said that Renga did not give up his tradition, his principles, his caste and community. Still it is with him only. She expressed in such a way. That too she did after assuring, after confirming that the holy thread like this is still on the chest of Renga. So that lady too had gone. So everybody, a huge crowd of the village people came and they noticed and they talked and they wished the Renga and they were much impressed by the attitude and with good intention they had dispersed. Now only the narrator, he was standing there. The narrator was alone there. And he wanted to talk to Renga. He came near to Renga. He fondly called, "Hi, my dear boy, how are you? How was your studies?" He asked gently, genuinely, fondly, he asked him, he inquired him about his studies, about his health, about his staying in the modern city. No one in such a way inquired him. So he was very much impressed by the attitude of the narrator. He went near to him. He just bent down and he touched the feet of the narrator. And he wished him to bless him. And he did namaskara. He did namaskar to him. So he bent down, he touched the feet of that narrator, and then he did namaskar. So, with great devotional love towards the narrator, the village young boy, young man, Renga told him, Yes, I am living, I am quite well with your blessings. I am leading a good life. I am quite well. Physically, spiritually, mentally, I am quite okay with your blessings. I am doing good with your blessings. He told him like that. The narrator was very much impressed by the lovable words of Renga. What a nice young man, Renga. He didn't change at all. The city study, the city staying did not affect his culture. His staying in the modern city did not affect his principles, tradition, culture. And he was the same Renga whom he had seen 6 months ago. That is before he had gone to Bangalore for higher studies. So the narrator was very much impressed. When he touched his feet for his blessings. But nowadays, do you know, children, it is very rare to find such types of children as well as students. You have to respect your parents. During your, suppose, when you celebrate your birthday, you have to go and get the blessings of your parents. You must do namaskar. You should touch the feet of your parents and you should get their blessings. You should get the blessings of the God. You should get the blessings of your teachers. You should get the blessings of the elders. So all their blessings are considered very much essential for your prosperity. Okay, fine. So this village young man, Renga, did all these things. So he was very much impressed with the narrator. The narrator was very much impressed by the general attitude as well as attitude of Renga. Then he fondly discussed with him, genuine talk he had with him. After pleasant talk for some time, after having pleasant talk with Renga for some time, the narrator had decided to leave the place. He wished him once again. He greeted him once again. then he just left the place. Have you ever seen a village boy like Renga? It's quite rare. Because the attitude they have, till they have respect in their mind for the elders, but they don't know how to show it to them. That is another criteria. It is very rare to find young man like Renga, especially in the village. As on the same day afternoon, so after wishing Renga, the narrator Shyama had gone to his home. On the same day afternoon, Renga had decided to go and meet the narrator when he was at his rest. So he went to his home with a couple of oranges as a formal, we used to do during our formal visit. He went and had a talk with the narrator. They had a very pleasant talk for some time. Narrator asked him many things about his studies and the usefulness and the how he spent his valuable time there, and so many things he asked him about his studies as well as about his future plan. He also inquired the Renga, the village young boy, about his future plan. So they had a pleasant talk with each other. Their conversation, their discussion was very useful. So Renga find it very useful, and his regards for the narrator is very high. Now he had a good opinion of the narrator, and in the same manner, the narrator also, after having talked with Renga, come to a conclusion that he was a boy and he was a young man of principles, and he had a very good opinion about the traditional culture of the people of that village, and he had a good opinion of Renga also. Then the narrator asked him about his opinion about the marriage. So he thought, as a well-wisher of Renga, the narrator wanted him to get married. Therefore, the narrator asked Renga about his opinion, about marriage. Then he opened his heart. He told he has to find a good girl for his marriage. So now he is not going to get married. He has to wait for some time. He will wait for some time. After some time only, he will go for marriage. Before that, he expressed his opinion about what type of girl he wants to marry. He expressed openly. He wants to find a suitable girl for himself. He wants to find a suitable girl himself for his marriage. And more than that, he expressed his opinion, his view about the bride. In those days, you know that well, children, arranged marriage was in force. It was practiced everywhere. People would like to go for arranged marriage. But our young man, Renga, he doesn't have a good faith on arranged marriage. He himself wants to find a bride, and he wants also the bride to be matured. He wants such type of a girl. She should be a matured girl. Then only both can understand each other. That was Renga's opinion. Why he wants to select a matured girl? Because she only could understand him well, and he could understand her well. Therefore, he wants to select a matured girl as his life partner. So that was his opinion. And more than that, he was against the child marriage. But it was quite prevalent in those days. Child marriage was quite prevalent in those days. And people like to go for marriage when they are very young. They don't know what is life. They cannot have proper understanding, the bride and bridegroom. They don't have proper relation between them. They fail to understand each other because of their young age. Therefore, Renga was not in favor of such a child marriage. He wants to go for a marriage after some time. And more than that, he put another condition. He wants to marry a girl whom or he has to impress. He has to be impressed. So he wants to marry a girl whom he liked very much. Or the girl should impress him. He wants to marry such type of girl. So he expressed his view about the marriage. He wants to go for marriage after some time. He himself wants to find a life partner for his marriage. And he wants to select a matured girl to get married. He had no favor for child marriage. And at the same time, he doesn't favor the arranged marriage also. Because all of a sudden when the parents arrange for the marriage, that was his opinion, that they cannot understand each other well. And then he also expressed his view about the child marriage to the narrator. Children should not get married at their young age. If they do so, they cannot understand each other properly. So many marriages failed. Though marriages are heavenly made, it is made in the heaven. Of course, that is correct. Our elders used to say. Okay, fine. So Renga had expressed his opinion. And he wants to marry a girl who impressed him much. So when he expressed all these things, the narrator was very much impressed, but at the same time, he also told him, till he get a girl with all such things, he liked to remain as a bachelor. Unless otherwise, if I get a girl whom I like most, who is a matured girl, I won't go for marriage. I would like to remain as a bachelor till I get such type of a girl. This is my condition. So he openly expressed his view about the marriage. But the narrator wanted Renga to get married because he was a well-wisher of Renga. His the expression, remain bachelor till he get a good girl, pained him much. So he felt hurt by that word. So he had decided, anyhow, he himself have to find out a good bride for Renga because he was an innocent boy, innocent young boy. Therefore, it is his duty. It is more than a father. He wants to find a suitable girl for Renga. Then immediately he thought of Rama Rao. There was a man in the village, Rama Rao. His niece, her name was Ratna. Actually, she has lost her parents, both father and mother. So she was brought up by his uncle Rama Rao. What type of girl is she? About a few words about Ratna. Actually, she had a good culture, she had good tradition, and she was a virtuous lady. And more than that, as she comes from city or town, she had good characters, and she is good also in playing the veena and harmonium. And she is divinely beautiful girl. She is a divinely beautiful girl. So her charm and good personality, good character, nobility, her honesty, transparent honesty, all these things made her naturally a suitable choice as a bride. So now the narrator had decided she was the right choice for Renga. And he also decided Renga, who was equally good in all these things, therefore he himself considered he was the best groom for that bride. So the narrator came to a conclusion that Ratna was the best choice, an elegant, beautiful, divinely beautiful girl, a girl of good character, a girl with transparent honesty, good attitude, and she is good in playing musical instruments also. She can be a good wife for Ranga. At the same time, Ranga can be a good husband for any girl. That was the opinion of the narrator. Therefore, he himself decided that Ratna was the right choice for Ranga and Ranga was the right choice for Ratna. The narrator himself had decided. So now, next, he wants to go for the next step. He planned for a situation. He wants to create a situation where both bride and groom can meet each other. It should be an accidental one. It should not be a pre-planned one. He wants to have such things. So, he wants to make an arrangement or he wants to make a situation, create a situation where both bride and groom can meet with each other. When they meet each other, they can express their view, they can exchange their view, and more than that, the narrator wants to know whether he will like, whether he would like Ratna or not. That was his idea. Therefore, for that, he devised a plan. What plan he has made? Yeah, let me explain, children. He had a plan to make the narrator Shyam, he had a plan to meet Ranga, to meet Ratna. What plan he had made? See, I will explain. So, plan for meeting. Plan for meeting. So now, narrator Shyam went to Rama Rao's house. He met Rama Rao's wife there. Then he told her, I have buttermilk for you, for your family. You kindly sent Ratna to my house, to my home to fetch it. So the narrator told Rama Rao's wife in such a way, he used to supply the buttermilk for the entire Rama Rao's family, and he was an elderly person in the village, so everyone have a good respect on him. Therefore, he went and told Rama Rao's wife to send Ratna to his home to fetch the buttermilk. Yes, she accepted. Yes, I will send Ratna. You please kindly send it to her. Then Ratna came to our narrator's house. She, on the day, she wore a grand sari. In that sari, she was looking an angel. She was very beautiful. She was looking a divinely beautiful girl on the day. She came in the grand sari to narrator's house. At the same time, the narrator sent for Ranga also. He wants both bride and groom to meet each other surprisingly. So he asked Naratna to come in and he asked her to sit in his room. And then when he was talking with her, the narrator requested her to sing a song because the narrator knew well that she had a sweet voice. She was good in singing also. She was good in playing musical instrument also. So he requested her to sing a sweet voice. To sing a sweet song in a sweet voice. She readily agreed. She started to sing a sweet song in a sweet voice. So he was very much impressed by the sweet voice of the girl Ratna. At that time, what happened? Yeah, our hero, that is Ranga, came to the steps of narrator's house. When he reached the steps, he heard such a sweet voice. Wow! Who is singing there? What a sweet voice. What a sweet song. He just stopped on the threshold. He did not want to disturb the sweet voice. But he wanted to know who was that singer. We are very much curious to know. Suppose if it happened to you, suppose you want to visit your friend, you want to get something and so visited your friend's house. Suppose if you hear someone is singing there, definitely want to know who is singing there. In the same, with the curiosity, he wants to know the singer. Therefore, he just peeped through the the gap of the door. Through that gap of the door, then inside what happened? She was singing and she just noticed the light which comes through the gap of the door get blocked because he was standing there. Then she understood someone was standing at the doorstep. She immediately stopped singing. Then he opened the door, he entered the room. Then what happened? The narrator, wow, welcome, come on my dear, come on, please come and take your seat. He provided, he asked him to sit on the chair. Then Ratna moved aside and she stood there, hanged her head like this. Then repeatedly Ranga glanced Ratna. He developed an immediate or instant liking for her. He liked her. He was very much impressed by the elegance of that girl. She was standing there as a statue, a beautiful statue, hanging her head like this out of her shyness and coyness. It's a quite common found with the girls. So she was standing there. And now Ranga asked her to excuse him for disturbing her. When she was singing, her song gets disturbed by his arrival. And if she wish, immediately he would take his return. He would like to leave the place. He told her, but he was not ready to move from that place. That was noticed by that girl. So she got shy. So out of her shyness and coyness, she ran into another room. She hid herself behind the door. So her shyness, coyness, elegant beauty, her innocent talk, and her sweet voice, everything attracted Ranga to a greater extent. Now all his principle about the marriage, she was just 11 years old only. So all his principles about the marriage, he has just put down. Now he had developed instant liking for her. He repeatedly glanced at Ratna. He was very much impressed by the beauty of Ratna. Then he slowly asked the narrator, may I know who was that girl? But the narrator noticed all these things. Narrator was very happy because that is he wants to happen. He wants Ranga to like Ratna and he wants Ratna to like Ranga. He wants both of them go for marriage with each other. He wants Ranga to get married to Ratna. That was his wishes. Therefore he was so happy. When the narrator came to know that Ranga has developed an initial liking for Ratna, then he explained who was she, everything, from where she had come, who was the guardian, everything he explained. But at the same time, to his shock, the narrator told him a lie also, that she was recently married. Then the narrator noticed the changes on the face of Ranga. Instantly he became so sad. What? When he asked the narrator about that girl, he wished that she was not married. She would not get married. In such a way only Ranga talked with the narrator Shyam. That was also noticed by the narrator. So he really wants to test Ranga, whether he likes that girl, really he likes that girl or not. Therefore he told him a lie that recently the girl Ratna got married. Immediately he became so sad. The waves of sadness just started to spread on his face. That was also noticed by the narrator. Wow, this boy really liked Ratna very much. He wants to go for marriage with her. He wants to marry Ratna. Very nice, very nice. He thanked God, he thanked heaven for happening of such things. Then he told, okay, tomorrow I will meet you. So with the words of farewell, he went to his home with a heavy heart. He thought all along the way, wow, what a beautiful girl, what a sweet voice. But she was married. What a misfortune. He thought himself in such a way. Next day, what happened? This narrator went and meet an astrologer. Went and meet astrologer Shastri. Meeting an astrologer. Shastri. So the narrator went and met the astrologer Shastri. He explained him all his plan. So he needed the help of astrologer. He tutored him. He asked him to say all these things in a recorded manner, in such a way, without changing any words. The narrator requested the astrologer to say the words to the to Ranga. He accepted, he agreed for his plan. He also expressed his help for the successful plan of the narrator. He was ready to extend his helping hand to the narrator. Okay, fine. So the next day, the narrator took Ranga to the house of astrologer. And then he wished astrologer. Astrologer also asked him about his return from the Bangalore. And he asked him, he inquired a few words about his studies and all other things. They discussed some things in general. Then the narrator told the astrologer, sir, he is a very good young boy. He is a boy of good manners. And now for a few days, he has been worrying about something. He had some problem in his mind. I don't know what is it about. Can you say it is about what? He has been suffering with such problem in his mind. So something is persisting him. Something is giving pain to his mind and heart. So I don't know what is his problem with what he has been suffering. Kindly tell me. Then the astrologer just acted as if he were doing some calculations. He moved his lips in such a way. So he started to refer the famous books of astrology, the movement of the stars. All those books gives the benefit about the position as well as the benefits of the stars. Then he asked Ranga, what is your star? But Ranga responded to him, sorry, I don't know my star. No problem. Then astrologer told him, no problem. Let me do some other calculations. He acted as if he was doing some calculations. After calculating certain things, he told the narrator, yes, now I could know the reason for his problem, because he was suffering with a problem, that is with the name of a girl. A girl was the real cause for his problem. He told him like that. So he was thinking about a girl. The name of that girl, then the narrator asked him, can you say it is the name of that girl who is really caused for his problem? Then the astrologer told him, yes, he has been thinking a girl in his mind. It is not a problem. Actually, that caused. So he was suffering from that only. Then the astrologer explained him in such a way. Now the narrator gave another clue. Yes, he was suffering from thinking of a girl in his mind. Very nice, very nice. May I know the name of that girl, whom she might be, who is giving trouble to my boy Ranga? Who was that girl? About the name, he asked the astrologer. Then the astrologer gave another hint. Yes. Okay, children, next. When the astrologer told the narrator about the thing which really caused for the problem of that Ranga, yes, he told him that he was thinking about the girl. That was his problem. Other than that, he had nothing in his mind. Then next, the narrator asked him another question. Can he give him the name of that girl? Who was she? The narrator asked the astrologer in such a way. Then the astrologer told him, yes, the girl had a name of such a precious stone which is found in the ocean. The astrologer just gave a hint. He told the narrator that my astrology says that the girl who really impressed this Ranga had the name of a precious stone which was found in the ocean. Then the astrologer told the name of some of the precious stones, Kamala, Pearl or Ratna. Then the narrator intentionally asked the question, may it be the name of Kamala? Maybe. Then he asked another question, may it be the name of Ratna? Yeah, of course. And more than that, he also asked him, what your astrology stars, the position of the stars says about Ranga's the problem and solution. Is there any solution for Ranga's problem? Yes. Then the astrologer told definitely he would go for marriage with the girl whom he liked most. Maybe Ratna. He gave a hint. Then the narrator gently asked him, do you love? Have you been thinking about Ratna all these days? He told yes. He accepted. Yes, yes, yes. Now he was so happy. But again he wants to test the real love and of Ranga. Therefore he told him, wow, you like Ratna. But unfortunately she was married. Recently she was married. But the astrologer told, whatever it may be, I don't know all such things. But the position of the stars says that he will win the hands of Ratna, no doubt in it. He will definitely get married with Ratna. The astrologer strongly told him like that. Now, it gave his plain relief to Ranga. Then both the narrator as well as Ranga came out of the house of astrologer. When they were coming back to their house, they crossed Rama Rao's house, and the niece of Rama Rao, that is the Ratna, was standing at the doorsteps alone. Now he asked Ranga to wait there for some time. He went in the house of Rama Rao, then he came back. Now see that the boy Ranga was eagerly, earnestly waiting what he will say. Then the narrator told him, "Hey, Ranga, here is a happy news. Sorry, unfortunately, I've been misguided by someone else that Ratna was married. I told you already, but that was not correct message. Based on someone's false message, I told you like that. But still, she has not yet married." Now Ranga became so happy. He was so happy. He expressed his happiness over his face. That was noticed by the narrator. The narrator asked him, are you ready to go for your marriage with Ratna? He instantly expressed his wish. Then the narrator arranged and he talked with the parents as well as the elders. So Ranga successfully married Ratna. So for what he has told, that he would like to marry a girl who has to impress him very much. Actually, he was very much impressed by the honest behavior and the elegance. So he was very happy to get the hands of Ratna as his life partner. Both of them united, unified marriages are heavenly made. Marriages are made in the heaven. So it happened in Renga's life also. He never expected such things to happen. Though he had such a wish in his mind, such a principle, such an idea about his life partner, it happened in his life because of God's grace. Because of the blessing of God, he got married with Ratna. Okay, fine. So after some years, the narrator Shyama was invited for a grand feast, for a dinner. He went. What was that function? So the narrator was invited for the function of birthday celebration. Yeah, Renga's son. He named his son Shyama after the name of the narrator. He told, "My named my son after your name only. That is Shyama." He was just 3 years old. He is celebrating his son's birthday on that day. So he invited the narrator for the birthday party. He was so happy to see the son of Renga. The young boy ran towards the narrator and he put his arms around the leg of the narrator. He was very much impressed. Then he took the baby in his hands. He kissed the baby on his cheek and he put a gold ring on the tiny and tender finger of that child. He gave that ring as a birthday present to the child. Everyone was so happy with the attitude of the narrator. And more than that the narrator came to know that his wife Ratna was 8 months pregnant. She was going to deliver soon another baby. She was a pregnant lady. She was pregnant of 8 months old. When he happened to hear these things, he was so happy. So it shows how they are leading a happy marriage life. Then the narrator asked him, "When your wife is pregnant, then who will take care of this young boy?" Then he happily told, "Yes, I have invited my sister. She has come with my mother also. Both of them take care of my wife as well as my child." So it shows his attitude towards the joint family. So he wants to live in a joint family. He wants to live with his parents. That is quite nice. We should live with our elder parents, with our elders. So at the concluding remarks, at the conclusion, the narrator says, really, the one of the general attitude of the peoples of South India, that is, they prefer the joint family. So the decision of Renga also shows that how much he loved the joint family system. So the happy marriage. So that is the happy end of the story. I hope students got very good idea about Renga's marriage. That was let me sum up in a nutshell. So Renga was a village boy. He was the first boy who sent to city for higher studies. He has completed his studies and he came back to the city, to his village. People are very much impressed by unchanging attitude of the Renga. Then the narrator Shyama was also very much impressed by the attitude of Renga. He was a real well-wisher. So being impressed by his submissive character and behavior, he wants to get him married. Therefore, he found a suitable girl, that is Rama Rao's daughter, as Rama Rao's niece. She has lost both her parents. So she was a nice bride for him. And he also decided Renga was a nice groom for that girl. As an elderly person, so he has rightly decided such things. So he arranged for a meeting. Both of them met with each other. They exchanged their hearts. Both of them liked each other. So with the help of the astrologer, and with the help of the parents and other elders of that village, so he planned for their marriage. So the marriage was very successful. So he got married with Ratna. So they lead a happy married life. After some years, Ranga invited the narrator for the birthday celebration of his son, 3 years old son. Then at the time she was an 8 months old pregnant lady. So he invited his parents also to come and stay with them to take care of his wife as well as the children. So that was the happy end of this story. Thank you children. And just to go through the story of your text snapshots, you could easily understand because all the hard words have been discussed within today's class. And even then, if you have any doubts, just mark it and you can get it clarified with me at any time. And see, you will be followed by the notes for this lesson also. Kindly write all the class works neatly in your own handwriting in the note, in the classwork note. Okay, then whenever you are asked to submit note for correction, at the time without fail you have to submit it. In the next video class, preferably I have planned to teach you the short writing composition. We can go for such a write short composition. Okay, it will be useful for you. Thank you children, have a nice day.